Hello, everybody. It's Jonathan N. Dorn, CPA, strongest CPA in Florida. We're gonna do a sales receipt now. Last one we did an estimate to invoice, and so this a sales receipt is you know, say somebody just say it's like you bought a candy bar or a cash register. You know, you buy a candy bar at a store. You know, you don't do an estimate or an invoice for that. You just get a receipt. So, in this instance, we're gonna say that you're receiving money and you didn't do an estimate or an invoice. You know, which will happen. Well, we're in Dorn CPA this time because I wanted to do a bank balance transaction that actually happened and go through this with what actually happened in my business. So anyways, sales receipt. So that's under customers. So we got a sales receipt over here. So we're going to do the sales receipt. Now to make this work, I did this in 8/30/0831. Sorry. In the sales receipt, I'm going to change this 08/31/15. I have to change that because of, oh, come on, man. 08/31. We have to start this over. Jesus. Oh my God. Sorry about that, guys. But just to make that work. Now we're just going to start a new customer, Jane Doe. Yeah, we're going to add her. We're going to save. Okay. Jane came by and I did some consulting. I did some consulting work for her. Came by and I did consulting for a tax payment. Now, how much did I charge her? See, I charged her $50. Ooh, not $500. We charged her $50. Okay, so an amount received, $50. She paid me $50. She paid me on a credit card, though. I don't think that's really made on this matter. She paid me on the credit card. Now, we're depositing to undeposited funds. And this is kind of one of the QuickBooks things that we'll see. We'll get into the next one. But let's save this. Because you do this with a linked bank transaction, which I hope you have the QuickBooks Online. So we'll see what happens here with this sales receipt. We're going to save it. Sales receipt 1008 saved. All right. Let's get out of here. Now we can look. We can go look at. You can always go look at the sales receipts or pretty much anything. The top left-hand corner, we can go look. Oh, that's the one we did for Jane Doe, $831 for $50. And that is the receipt that we did going to undeposited funds. Okay, cool. My mouse. Ugh. Ich. Anyways, so where would that be? Well, that's a bank account. That's going to be an asset. We'll go to report. I have my custom reports. I have the balance sheet reports. So look, undeposited funds, $50. And where is that $50? There it is. Consulting Jane Doe. You know, and I just love, you know, highlighting everything. And this is where that comes from. So, anyways, that is a sales receipt. Thank you for watching, and hope you learned something. Hope you enjoyed it. and take care. Bye.